and welcome to VCC TV. Bangkok headquartered MQDC is launching its first project in India with a co-work project. To talk more about it and its future plans, I have with me Amy, who's the director of MQDC India. Thanks for talking to us. My first question to you would be, tell me a little about India real estate market. Why did you choose India to start your first co-work project outside of Thailand?
Okay, so as everyone knows, India is a very huge market, huge potential, and a very young population. India also has a very numerous startup community. Mm-hmm. I think India is the number three in the world in numbers of startups. And so with that and the vision that we have, so we have a global vision of developing future leaders, young talents, you know, wherever we go. So with that and all the opportunities of India, that's why we're entering with a co-working space.
Interesting. And tell us a bit about the project. You know, what kind of parameters have you included? What kind of target audience do you have in mind? You know, what kind of elements are you incorporating? Tell me a bit about the project.
So we're entering India very soon with a Wisdom Club. Wisdom Club, we call it an inspiration hub. So it's like a co-working space, but it's a space that it's like a one-stop shop where we hope to inspire everyone that comes in, whether it's members or non-members. So inside the space, there's many things, such as a beautiful cafe that's also open to the public, not just members. We have an event space where we hope to host many series of events, both on the business side as well as on the personal development side as well. We have a play zone, we have a dream lab, we have many other spaces that people can just come and work and relax all under the same roof.
Okay.
The target group are young entrepreneurs, students, startups, SMEs, and even enterprise corporate teams as well.
Interesting. Nice. But India is a interesting market from different perspectives. You know, you are venturing with your first project. What kind of challenges did you face while setting up the project?
Along the way, so I've started this journey for about over a year now. I've been lucky. I think most of my journey has been rather smooth. But of course, there has been a lot of challenges along the way. Most recently, I would say, you know, some building restrictions, regulations that as a new entry, I'm not used to that and I haven't been aware. So that had to take a little adjustments because it affects our design and timeline as well.
Okay, I understand. You're also currently hosting an innovation challenge and an innovation campaign. What kind of entrepreneurship and startup ecosystem are you going to promote through your incubation center and the co-work space that you're setting up? You know, what kind of encouragement that people in startups can expect from that center?
So a few months back, earlier this year, we launched a campaign called Wisdom Innovation Challenge, a startup challenge, basically. So we welcome applications from Pan India in five sectors: lifestyle and wellness, health, education, property, and construction. And so over 100 applications, and then we shortlisted about 11 to the pitch day in May with our partners Turning Ideas and Thai. And then the jury selected five winners.
Correct.
And as part of the prize, we welcomed them into Bangkok for half a month as part of the incubation.
Nice.
Where we hope that they can expand their network, connections, and expertise beyond India. And as part of that incubation in Bangkok, just last week, we had a Texas event in Thailand. It's called the Texas Global Summit, where MQDC India, we hosted an India Pavilion at Texas, showcasing our five startups.
Correct.
Yes.
And how does that align with the overall philosophy of the company? I mean, promoting entrepreneurship, promoting startup, how does that align with the overall philosophy and goal of MQDC?
So the overall goal is to mentor young people and startups.
Correct.
Mentor in terms of providing more opportunities as well as self-development as well. So giving them the opportunity to come outside of India, meet foreigners in Thailand and the Thai way and expand their connections, I think this is a very valuable opportunity for all of them.
And because you are going there, going to India with your first project, what are your views? What kind of market, from your perspective, how's the market? You know, is it difficult? Is it a tricky market? Is it a huge market? You know, how would you sort of describe the Indian real estate market?
I think every market is tricky in its own way.
Yeah.
So I can certainly say that the Indian property market has improved drastically over the past few years with RERA, you know, GST, demonetization, FDI policies.
Correct.
So that makes people like us enter the Indian market much easier. ease of doing business is very easy as well. Mm-hmm. And I think we've been very lucky in finding good partners to help us along the way.
Mm-hmm. And take us through the, you know, projects that you have lined up for India. Maybe co-work, maybe normal project, maybe a mixed use or a resi project. You know, what is the pipeline like?
Okay, so the first path that we're taking is co-working space, this wisdom club we're doing. We will be opening that in 2-3 months in South Delhi.
Mm-hmm.
And in the pipeline, we plan to open more, mainly in NCR first, and then we plan to roll it out in other metro cities along the way after we do some more research and studies.
Correct.
And another path is property development. We are a property developer, and that is something we are exploring.
Mm-hmm.
But that's to be seen about which metro cities and which asset classes.
Okay. Great.